Kaden, why did your school call me and tell me you weren't in fourth period today?
I don't like the science teacher. She smells like farts. So I went off campus with my friends.
Kaden, that's not okay. I won't tolerate that.
Oh, God, calm down, Mom. It was just one class.
Well, make sure it doesn't happen again, Kaden Jackson. I'm not playing with you.
I'm just going to tell you right now, it's going to happen again.
Kawhi, I want to get your father out the house this weekend. He's been very depressed ever since he moved back in, so I'm leaving you in charge of your brothers.
Yeah, I think that'd be good for her mom. I think he really needs that.
I just think he needs time to adjust with being back in the house with his real family. You know, his light-skinned family. The right family, you know? Kalani.
Karen.
I have asked you several times not to call me by my first name. I am your mother. You will address me as such.
Oh, Karen, look at you trying to put your foot down. You want to take my dad out this weekend? He doesn't even like you, okay? I overheard a phone call with him and Grandpa, and he pretty much told Grandpa that you took him away from his Nubian queen.
I didn't take him from no Nubian queen, okay? He left her for his Queen Elsa. He left her for his Ice Queen. And you know what, Kalani? Effective immediately, you are grounded.
What are these words you're making up? What is grounded? I've never heard of that before. It means you're confined to your room. No TV and no phone. No laptops. No PS5.
That's right, mister. Now you take back what you said about me taking your father from that Queen Jemima.
Karen, if you ground me, I'll run away and go get somebody's daughter pregnant.
Kalani, give me your phone. Kalani, give me your phone.
No.
Kalani, since when do you back talk me? You are acting like your other brothers. Your father's other children. You weren't raised like that. You know what? I'm gonna...
What?
Oh, I'm gonna...
What?
Oh! Oh! What was that?
Hey, Mama, this is my friend Latoya.
Sardines.
What? Is this the little girl that I caught you with last week and she had your room smelling like under the sea? Mama, can we go to the movies this weekend? Sure, if your brother decides to go with you. Mama, no, because then he gonna wanna bring his boyfriend and then he gonna treat me like I'm a baby. Sounds like a personal problem. Latoya, is it? How old are you?
I'm 17.
Oh, so you're a predator. My son just turned 16.
No, we're in the same grade.
Oh, so you're repeating the 11th grade. Mama, can we go to the movies? Yes or no?
Can you clean the piss off the toilet seat or no? Can you clean that dirty ring around the bathtub off or no? Can you take a shower without being told to or no? Can you stop introducing me to females that smell like fishbowl or no?
Mama!
Ma'am, what exactly are you trying to imply?
Sweetheart, I need you to seek medical attention ASAP. Your scent is offensive.
Ma'am, I smell like blossoms and cherries. Ask your son.
You want to take her to the movies? I need you to take her to the nearest pharmacy so she can gain control of that pH balance.
You know what? I can't do this, Kyrie. Your mom is rude. I'm leaving.
What was that?
Kyrie, she smelled like China sea.
Really, Mama?
I'm not ready for you to date. I'm not ready for you. I'm not used to you bringing females. I'm not ready for you to date, okay?
Get out of my kitchen. Mama, I don't have a clear understanding on why I can't go to my friend's house or take a girl out to the movies without you being rude, but Brian and Savon get to do whatever they want to do. You know, for the past couple of weeks, I have been trying to respond to y'all's attitudes differently. Try to be more understanding, you know, of y'all's frustration, if I, it was something I said to cause you to have the attitude. But Kyrie, I need you to control your emotions before I let mine loose. I wonder if you can still smack your lips if they're busted. Hey, mama, this is my girlfriend, Jasmine.
Hi, Miss Jackson. It is so nice to finally meet you. I've heard nothing but positive things about you.
Interesting. Especially because I've heard nothing about you. Mama, this is my girlfriend, Jasmine.
I heard you the first time, Savon. What do you want? Are you about to be out all night?
Please make sure you take a plan B in the morning. I do not need any more grandchildren. You do know he's a teenage father, right?
Yes, I do. Miss Tamika, where did you get your bonnet? I love it.
I got it from the beauty supply store.
It's beautiful. And I love your son. He is an amazing father.
So, Jasmine, tell me about yourself.
Well, I currently attend UTSA. I'm trying to get my degree in business management. I own my own apartment. I own my own car. I was raised in a church. And for work, I file people's taxes.
Oh, see, I knew it was something. I knew it was something off about you. See, a mother knows. A mother always knows. You out here scamming people. Is that what you want, Savon? Somebody who's out here scamming people out of their taxes?
No, ma'am. I work for an actual tax company. I'm actually one of the assistant managers there. I've been trying to get Savon on board so he can, you know, gain some financial stability.
It's nice to meet you, Jasmine. Really nice to meet you. Mama, are you serious? All Savon is going to do is get her pregnant and you're going to be a grandmother of two.
Kyrie, I have told you to control your emotions before I let mine loose.
Let them loose then.
Savon and Jasmine, could y'all clear the room, please?
Versace, why every time you come over here, his diaper isn't changed?
Well, change it, Tamika. He's a baby, so he's going to piss every 5 seconds. You know what? I'm just going to keep him for the weekend, and your incompetent ass can go do whatever it is you need to do.
Miss Archie, what do you want? Savon is not here.
I didn't come for Savon.
Of course you did. You're the type of baby mama who uses the child as an excuse to see the father.
Lie again.
Mama, can I use the car to go see Trenton?
Brian, leave me alone.
What's up, Mama?
Oh, shit.
Jasmine, have you met Versace, the baby mama?
No, I've been trying to avoid that at all costs.
What exactly does that mean, Jasper?
Can y'all not do this in front of my grandbaby, please?
Savon, you've been avoiding our child for weeks. And for what? For this chick?
I haven't been avoiding my son. I've been avoiding you. Why are you here? That's what I want to know.
No one is speaking to you, Jermaine.
It's Jasmine.
Whatever the hell it is, your wig is giving broke and tired.
My wig costs more than your life, and I know little Miss Awkwafina with the low IQ score isn't talking. Little Miss, I need welfare but can't spell welfare. Little Miss, I forgot the PIN number to my EBT card. Let me call my mama and get it. Isn't talking.
pregnant.
Savon, take her to the clinic.
It's not mine.
You better be lying.
Mama, you gotta believe me, that is not my baby.
I don't know, Savon. I took her to the clinic and she is pregnant.
It's not mine though, Mama. Come on, you know the game. She clearly is mad because I'm with Jasmine.
How is Jasmine, by the way? You know, I would never admit this to you, but I actually like her.
She ain't talking to me at the moment, but when I take this DNA test, it's gonna clear all this up.
You better hope so. Because I'm still coming to terms with being a mother and a grandmother.
What's up, bro? How you doing, Miss Tamika?
Hey, Rashad, how's your mom?
She doing good. You ready?
Where y'all going?
We're just going to the mall, Mama. Bro, why did Versace pop up the other day? For what? I don't know, but all of a sudden, she's pregnant. She's pregnant?
Yeah, bro. Crazy, right?
Did she happen to say by who?
She's saying it's me, but I never touched her. She's clearly mad because I'm with Jasmine, and that's why she's doing this.
Hey, bro, I'm gonna wait for you in the car. All right. Mama, you gotta believe me.
I believe you.
What changed?
How long have you known Rashad?
Since we were kids, you know that.
How long has he known Versace?
As long as she's known me, but I mean, they don't really interact. Why?
Why, Mama? Savon, I know you have some of my intuition in you. You just told your homeboy that your baby mama was pregnant, and he seemed very concerned. As a matter of fact, he asked you, did she happen to mention who the father was? Hold on. Let mama handle this. Let me handle this. I'm going to set up a meeting with Versace, and I want you to bring Rashad. Don't tell him that she's gonna be there. As a matter of fact, act like you don't know nothing. And let this all play out.
Tamika, why are me and my daughter here? We've already established that she's pregnant with your son's second child. You need to get Savon to stop populating.
In the meantime, tell your daughter to close her legs.
I've only been with Savon and only Savon, Tamika. I know you remember what happened last time you disrespected my child in front of me.
I do. I remember you being in the hospital with a concussion.
Why are we here?
Perfect timing.
Hey boys, how was the mall?
Vanessa, this is Rashad. Rashad, this is Vanessa.
I don't care who he is, Tamika. Why are me and my child here? Rashad! You know Versace. Versace, you know Rashad.
Mama, can we go?
Well, before you go, I just wanted to say congratulations. I am truly happy that I'll be a grandmother of two. In lieu of that, I have set up an apartment for you and Savon, and I'll be assisting you both until you're able to do it on your own. And what about his little girlfriend? Unfortunately, she is no longer in the picture. Okay. Under one condition. I'd like a DNA test. Tamika, you are... That won't be a problem. We've done it before.
Mama, I don't have to prove anything to her.
No, we gonna provide one. We ain't got nothing to hide. It's Savon's. Like the other one is Savon's.
So that won't be a problem. We will provide one.
Versace, you seem worried.
It's just a little swab in the mouth. You and Savannah have done it before. I don't want Savannah involved. But he currently is involved in my grandson's life. What happened? Why the sudden change? It's not Savannah's. What? I'm sorry, I didn't quite catch that.
Then whose is it?
Mama, can we please go?
Hell no! Tell us who the pappy is.
Leave me alone, Tamika!
No! Tell your mama whose baby it is, Versace!
Or I'm gonna tell her for you. As a matter of fact, you got 5 seconds to tell her. 5, 3, 4.
Fine! It's Kawhi's!
What? Who the hell is Kawhi?
Hello, Karen. Tamika, I know you don't know how to spell restraining order, and you might not even know what it means, but you are violating it right now. See, normally I would have put my hands on you by now, but I'm gonna let this news do that for me. I want you to meet Versace and her mother. Her name is Versace, like the brand. And what's her mother's name? Gucci? Dolce? Gabbana? My name is Vanessa. Do you have a son named Kawhi? Why is my child's name in your mouth? He's been seeing my daughter. My son is very friendly. I find him making friends with the strangest people. He's friends with the kids at his school that ride the little bus. He's been sleeping with my daughter, too. Well, my son likes to experiment on bizarre creatures.
Your son got my daughter pregnant.
What? Based on your facial expression, I can tell you know who this hood rat is. This is so ghetto. This behavior definitely came from your dad's side of the family. I'm gonna take you to the clinic to get tested for STDs and whatever plagues this girl might be carrying. Lady, you got one more time to disrespect my child. And as for whatever the hell she is conjuring up in her uterus, I want it 86'd immediately.
Oh!
My daughter's keeping this baby. And your son will be financially responsible for the baby and her and me for the rest of his life. As a matter of fact, we're going to take him to court to start the child support process. We're gonna take y'all for everything y'all got. How old is your daughter? She's 19. Why? You have two options, and these are very lenient options. You can either take your daughter to the clinic, or you can take her to the nearest police station, where she will be charged with statutory. My son is a minor. Good morning, Mama. You look so beautiful this morning. She's literally wearing the same bonnet and tired-ass robe she's been wearing for years. It's too early to whoop your little ass, Kyrie. I haven't even had my coffee yet. What do you want, Savon? So I was at the dealership yesterday trying to get a car, and they said I need a co-signer.
Have you had a conversation with your father about this? Why is it always me?
I much rather go through the parent who's been there since day one. The one who has broke her back trying to make sure I had a bright future. My mama. That was real smooth. What kind of car is it? It's a Hellcat.
A Hellcat?
Savon, you work at Chick-fil-A, and I know the Lord is not paying you Hellcat paychecks. So I will co-sign on something a little more cheaper, like a Honda Civic.
A Honda? Ew, mama, that ain't gonna work.
You gonna cry in your brand new Honda Civic, or are you going to cry in the passenger seat located in my car? I ain't had my coffee yet, boy. Leave me alone. Hello.
Who is this?
Ma'am, you called this number.
You sound like your name is Tamika Jackson. My name is Brandy Tolbert. My son's name is Devontae Tolbert. And I am calling in regards to your son, Brian.
Go ahead. I'm listening, Brandy Tolbert.
I've been noticing that your son has been in my home for the last 6 weeks and he's been staying the night.
Get to your point, Brandy Tolbert.
I know your son is a part of the LGBTQ community, but my son is not. And when I knock on my son's door and it takes him 5 or 10 minutes to open it, I have a problem with that.
Listen, you not being able to enter your son's room because he's too busy being bent over or bending my son over has nothing to do with me.
You keep your son away from my son. I will not allow him to corrupt my child.
Brandy, listen. Your son is gay and sexually active, okay? Seek some therapy if you cannot handle it, or get a glass of wine to cope. I do.
My son is not... You know what? I took my son, my healthy son, to the clinic to get tested, and his test results came back positive for chlamydia and herpes. Now pour a glass of wine for that bitch.
Mama Brian got that shit.
Well, Tamika, this is a step up from the last house you had. You went from a one-story to a two.
I don't ever recall inviting you to that one, so I'm confused as to why you've invited yourself to this one, Tina.
Sis, we just wanted to stop by because we,
Tommy, I am the oldest. I'll be the one letting Tamika know why we are here.
Tina, didn't nobody make you our spokesperson?
Yes, Tina, we can speak for ourselves. But I am the richest and oldest sibling, so I will speak first. I invited myself here today because I haven't seen or heard from you in 5 years, Tamika.
You haven't heard from me in 5 years because I do not like you, Tina. That's why. Now, why are you in my house?
Daddy is sick. And against my better judgment, he would like all of us under one roof for Thanksgiving. So I was thinking, we should have it at your house, Tamika. Now that you have all the space.
Now, why is he sick?
Why can't we have it here at your house, Tamika?
Because it's my house and I don't want nobody in my house right now, Tina.
Look, y'all, she thinks she's too good. I would say we can have it at my home located on the top of a hill in Killeen, Texas. But Daddy is here in San Antonio, and I don't want him to have to travel. I heard that beautiful home and that hill you live on is going into foreclosure.
You wish my home with my successful husband and 6 beautiful children was going into foreclosure.
Oh, you're claiming all 6 now? I know that biologically you were only able to give birth to 2.
It is really tragic to see that Michael has left you for a white woman.
It must be heartbreaking to know that your husband had to impregnate other women to get his other 4 children because you physically were unable to give him any more.
Michael says he wishes he never had any children with you. I'd much rather that than to be married to a man who pushes me down the stairs because I forgot to fix my hair in the morning.
Tamika!
Okay, that's enough.
Y'all do this every time. This is the problem.
Chris is getting better.
Thank you for stopping by. When I get the chance, I will go check on my daddy. We need to finish discussing Thanksgiving. Please get out of my house. I will not make the request again.
Your house? You mean your house that you're renting?
I do hope that you find a home for your family soon. I would hate to have to hear that Chris has knocked your head in between the washer and dryer next. Grandma, baby getting big. Can I hold him?
His mother will be here any second, so hold him at your own risk.
I ain't scared of that hood rat. I ain't scared of your hood rat, mama. Oh, he's so cute.
Okay, now, don't be getting no ideas, Jasmine.
Me and Savannah are definitely taking it slow.
Jasmine, I know my son has turned you into a pill popper every morning. No kids anytime soon. Outstanding. All right, Tamika, where my baby? Masashi, do you always let yourself into people's houses?
My child isn't here. Tamika, why is this stranger holding my baby?
Because she wanted to hold him.
Okay, so I'm assuming she'd like to get beat up too?
I see you stepped your wig game up, and I see you've stepped yours down. Your lace is showing. When you buy wigs, you should consider cutting the lace before applying the wig.
Tresemme or moisturizer could keep your wig under control. Or a brush. Or comb.
You should really start changing him more. I noticed when I changed him earlier, he had diapers rash.
So you're letting random strangers change my baby's diaper now, Tamika?
Get my baby up or I'm gonna have to put my hands on you. And then you'll go to jail for assault? I mean, you're already a murderer.
Oh, Jesus. What's that supposed to mean? Who did I murder?
Abortion queen? You don't recall your last monthly visit to the clinic?
Jasmine. Too soon.
Tamika, I'm really about to touch her. Take my baby out of her arms right now. You really gonna fight me in front of your son? Wow, you are mother of the year.
Shadi, I don't do too much of this back and forth, so you either give my baby up and catch this fade, or you ain't leaving this house until you do.
I will call the cops on you. I'm still trying to figure out how Savon went from a hood bitch to a scary ass hoe who doesn't have 20/20 vision. You know what? You ain't even worth it. I'm gonna take a page from your book. Give me my baby, or I'm gonna call the authorities and say that you kidnapped him.
Mama, it is something different about you today.
What?
You got some new perfume.
Your school called today and said that you missed fourth period. Keep skipping class, and I'm gonna skip all over your ass.
No, it's not the perfume. I can't put my finger on it. What is it that is different about you today?
Brian, you have really lost your mind. You have went from my favorite child to now my problem child. Okay? You and Kyrie have traded places.
I got it. You got a new robe. Wait. No, that's the same robe you've had for years. It's the wig. It's always that second child that wanna test the waters. Keep it up.
Mama, I hope you don't mind. I brought LaToya over again.
Hello again, Miss Tamika.
LaToya, it smells like you've taken care of your hygiene problem.
You know, at first, I thought you wore bonnets because you were bald-headed. I had no idea you actually had hair.
I don't think we've officially met. I'm Brian, and I will beat your ass.
Stop! Mama, she ain't mean it.
You know what? I feel pretty. I'm in a good mood. I'm not gonna let little stank get under my skin today.
Tamika, it turned out so good. I love it.
Thank you, Jasmine. The first genuine compliment I've gotten today.
I like the wig, Mama. I like the wig.
I like your hair, Mama.
Thank you. Who's this?
My name is LaToya. What are you?
I'm clean. And what is that scent I smell on you?
Bitch, Bath and Body Works.
I smell cottage cheese and ass.
Okay, Kyrie, y'all go ahead and have fun wherever y'all going.
Oh, Mama, I was gonna ask you if LaToya can spend the night.
You done lost your damn mind. No, she cannot.
Oh, but you let the Jasmine girl stay the night all the time.
LaToya, I don't like you. And I wish my son would find somebody else to date. Preferably somebody with good hygiene.
Kyrie, help me come to an understanding on why my dishes are not done.
Because I told Brian I'll switch turns with him. He was supposed to be washing her, Mama.
Who did I originally give the task to?
Me, Mama, but...
That is correct. I gave you the task, and I did not offer an alternative. But go ahead and ask your brother why he didn't commit to washing the dishes.
Brian!
Kyrie, don't be yelling my name like that.
I don't want to hear all that. Why the dishes ain't washed?
Didn't Mama tell you to wash them?
Didn't we make an agreement that I'll wash them next time if you wash them this time?
I do not recall.
So if I slap the piss out of you, would that jog your memory?
Kyrie, you slap me, I will beat your ass from the windows to the wall till you are completely out of your drawers.
Everything you say sounds gay.
Kyrie, I still haven't gotten my answer.
He's lying, Mama.
Well, the sad thing is both of my sons lie. So I don't know who's telling the truth and who's not. The thing is, I told you to wash the dishes, so you're gonna wash them. Brian, since you find the shit funny, you now have a task as well. I'd like my floors mopped. Savon, that little giggle sounded like you were volunteering to cut the grass.
Yeah, but I'm not.
But you are. I need to save $50 today anyway, so go cut my shit and I want all the grass swept up afterwards.
Mama, that's a lot. And Jasmine's coming over.
Oh, good. She can come do my hair and help you sweep up the grass if she wants to.
Mama, you live here too, so why don't you ever clean up after yourself? Why don't we have to clean up after you?
Do you have a death wish?
It's a fair question.
So a double homicide.
I mean, I ain't gonna say I haven't been thinking about that too.
Ooh, I'm gonna be found guilty on all three counts.
I withdraw my statement.
Think of it as retail. I'm the store manager and y'all are the employees. My job description is to supervise the operations in my house. Y'all's job is to operate.
We don't get paid though.
Oh, your pay is I let y'all live here for free. I want my ceiling fans clean too, all of them. I'll let y'all rock, paper, scissors on who's gonna be doing that.
I'm only gonna say this one last time. Y'all need to put the personal shit aside and start co-parenting. Like adults. Now, Brittany, you needed somebody to watch the baby tomorrow while you were at work? His daddy is right here.
Tanika, you just told him, so why do I need to?
Because he ain't my damn baby daddy. Open your mouth and communicate with the father of your child and tell him what you need.
Savannah, I have to work tomorrow. Can you watch the baby?
I'll work Monday.
Drug dealers don't have a set schedule. Y'all are always on call.
Girl, what evidence do you have that my son is dealing?
None. Now, he just told you that he works tomorrow, too. So what's your next move, mother of the year?
Well, can you find somebody to watch the baby?
You can ask my mama if she can watch him.
Tanika, can you please watch the baby tomorrow?
I want a copy of your schedule because I don't believe you. But sure, I will watch my grandbaby.
Hey, girl, so tomorrow I wanted to take you to get your nose done.
Oh, that sounds fun. I'm going to have my grandbaby with me, though.
Oh, that's perfectly fine.
Great. Sounds like a plan.
On second thought, I'm going to just take the baby to daycare.
Brittany, you are so predictable. You can't even afford daycare.
I also can't afford to go to jail if this girl decides to touch my baby after I've told her not to. You need to get over the fact that I'm going to be around your son a lot. You as a mother should want to get to know me. Savon has had several hoes around my baby. You just so happen to be the longest running hoe he's been with. If you want Savon back, just say that.
But I don't want him back.
Then you should really start acting like it. Because lately you've been acting like a bitter ass baby mama. You're quick to judge me, but you'll soon be just like me. A single mother. Having a confrontation with his next hoe. Here's the difference between me and you. I wasn't a quickie in the backseat of my mama's raggedy ass Chevy Impala who got pregnant because she lied about being on birth control, then a year later got pregnant by the younger brother because she could no longer have the older brother. That's the difference between me and you. You probably want to start being quiet, sis, because I will shut you down every time, sis. Next time you attempt to swing your hair back, make sure it all goes back. Tamika, I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, girl, see you tomorrow. Hello.
Hello, this is Principal James calling from Theodore Roosevelt High School. Am I speaking to Kyrie Jackson's mother?
I swear that little boy does not get tired of me whooping his ass.
Well, I do get tired of making these type of phone calls. Kyrie was in my office earlier for using vulgar language towards another student.
Why y'all always calling me first? Y'all never calling his daddy.
I tried your husband first. He didn't answer the phone.
He is not my husband.
And that is not my business.
All them kids at the school be cussing. Why is my son the only one getting in trouble?
I'm not exactly sure why you're worried about somebody else's child when your child is going to be in ISS for 4 days.
What the hell does ISS mean?
In school suspension. No further action is needed from you at this time.
You know what? I'm just going to take my baby to another school.
Yes, go ahead and help your child avoid experience and accountability.
James, you disrespect me one more time, I'm coming up to that school and causing a hostile environment.
Your son has already done that.
Bitch, have my baby waiting in the office. I'm about to pull up.
He will be waiting along with his withdrawal papers and security.
You are going to need more than security to handle me. I will be there in the next 15 minutes. Bye.
Well, Jasmine, you have a lovely home.
Thank you. I'm so glad that I finally got you guys over.
Is it just you here by yourself?
No, ma'am. I live with both my parents.
Interesting. What are your parents like?
Oh, they're amazing. My dad is a lawyer and my mom is a principal. You'll get along with them just fine.
My baby sure know how to pick them.
Jasmine, where's your bathroom?
It's down the hall to the left.
Okay, well, I'll be right back.
What you guys in here doing?
Nothing, Mom. Do you remember Savon?
I do. How have you been?
I've been good, Miss James.
Jasmine, I have never seen a toilet that had a faucet in it.
Tamika Jackson? Kyrie Jackson's mother?
Jasmine, this is your mother?
Yes, ma'am. Do you guys know each other?
This is the loudmouth ghetto parent I told you about who came into my school because I expelled her child for using profanity.
You forgot the part where when I came up there, your scary ass refused to talk to me woman to woman.
I would not get off my chariot to speak to any parent who is upset because their child is being punished for their behavior. Lady, you have no proof my child used profanity.
Kyrie came into my office and admitted it.
Yeah, right. You probably pressured my baby into taking the blame.
So you're one of those ignorant ass parents who doesn't think their child does anything wrong?
Mom!
Jasmine! You said that your parents were amazing. I'm assuming you're talking about your father because your mother is horrible.
Savon, you seem like a fine young man. You must get your charm from your father because your mother is ghetto.
Bitch, don't get stretched out in your own home.
I own too many weapons. I promise I won't get touched.
Oh, well then go get these weapons you speak of. Go retrieve them.
Mom.
I'd like to see them.
Mom.
No, I'd like to see them. Go get them, Veronica.
Mama, chill.
Listen, I already kicked your son out of my school, and now I'm kicking you out of my house.
Veronica, you have yet to get these weapons that you speak of. Where are the weapons?
So you're refusing to leave?
Where are the weapons?
If you do not leave my home right now, I will make sure your son doesn't get enrolled in any school in Texas. You will have to homeschool him.
Ma! Oh, you been lost your motherfucking mind!
Mom, calm bitch. Down.
Go get him! Mom. Go get him!
Mom,
go
get him!
Mom,
I'm waiting.
Get out! Jasmine, it's been nice, but your mother is the reason why you'll never see my son again. Let's go, Savon.
You were supposed to be picking the baby up at 4. It is 2:00. You were here 2 hours early. Why?
I need to talk to you.
If you are pregnant again, then you're at the wrong place. You know where Planned Parenthood is located.
I'm not pregnant. I don't give a shit. For God's sakes, Tamika, I am the mother of your grandson.
You must want that to mean something to me.
Yes. Could you for once be nice to me?
Why are you here 2 hours early, Brittany?
Me and my mama got into an argument. Oh. I don't give a shit. Go talk to a therapist, not me. She kicked me and the baby out.
She kicked my grandbaby out the house?
Yeah, she did. She decided that me, my baby, and her boyfriend couldn't coexist under the same roof. So she told me I had to find somewhere else to live.
I thought I was evil. Your mama is the devil. Well, my grandbaby is welcomed here forever. You, however, are going to have to figure something out. I got 3 boys and they don't like you.
And that's fair. Thank you. I'll just come see him whenever I get a chance, I guess.
You have 3 months to get it together. You need to find a job, a house, then you need to get out.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You will not be disappointed, Tamika. I promise I will not disappoint you. Oh, I know you won't because you're in my house now. And in my house, I like to harm people who disrespect me.
Are you gonna pick my son up and leave? I gotta talk to my mama.
She can't quite do that right now, because she'll be staying here.
Mama, do you hate me that much?
Baby, I don't hate you.
You ruined my chances of ever seeing Jasmine again. And now you're moving the one female that I cannot stand in the house with us?
Where is she gonna go? To a women's shelter with your son? Is that what you want?
Whatever. Mama, can you please go apologize to Principal James?
Come on, Mama. Think about Jasmine.
No.
Her mama won't let me see her.
Keyword. Her mama. Not your mama. Now take Versace upstairs and show her where she'll be sleeping. I need to run to the store.
What do y'all want?
I don't know why my mama allowed you to stay here, but let's get a couple things straight. Number one, whatever happens in this house while my mama is not here, you will keep to yourself. Let me dumb it down for you. I know you dropped out of high school. You are blind. You see nothing that goes on in this house. We each have chores that we are assigned. You will now take some of that responsibility. As a matter of fact, you'll be taking all the responsibility. We throw house parties when our mama goes to work at night. When these parties occur, you do not. Dumb it down for her, Kyrie. She does not have her high school diploma, which means she has trouble comprehending. You're not invited to the parties. Are you getting any of this? Because I don't feel like you're taking it seriously.
During the duration of my stay, you both will stay the fuck out of my way while I try to get Savon back. And if either of you try to hinder that,
Brian, I'll tell your mama that you have a 57-year-old sugar daddy somewhere in Atlanta. And Kyrie, I'll tell your mama that you knew about the 57-year-old sugar daddy.
Brian, what the hell is she talking about? Even if that were true, what makes you think my mama would believe you over me?
Now, Brian, did you not think I wouldn't gather my receipts? I screenshotted your profile on the Sugar Baby's website. Now, your mama operates like a lead detective, and she will investigate if this information is brought to her.
So you stay out of our way and we'll stay out of yours.
Not quite. You help me get Savon back and this information stays with me.
So that's why you conned your way into our house. The thing is, he loves Jasmine and hates you.
Okay, well y'all's task is to make him see that he's really in love with me and hates her.
Yeah, but Jasmine didn't sleep with our brother. You did.
You're right, I forgot about that. So we need to find a way to make her look worse than me.
Hypothetically speaking, let's say I have a way to make that happen. Will you leave?
Brian, you are not seriously considering this.
Look, Mama will kill me if she finds out and then kill you for being guilty by association.
If I get Savon back, sure, I'll leave.
You're right, my mama is a detective. So she'll call your mama, if she hasn't already, to find out what really happened and if you really got kicked out.
Kyrie, now you know I am not stupid. I knew your mama was gonna investigate. Which is why I made sure my mama changed her phone number and her location.
You strategic little bitch. We'll help you, and then you'll leave.
Mama, I have some information for you.
I'm listening.
Brittany has been lying to you.
Be more specific, Kyrie.
She never got kicked out of her mama's house. She's only here for Savon, and she's blackmailing Brian to help her.
You said that she was blackmailing your brother. What does she have on him?
Mama, the bottom line is that this girl played you.
She will be dealt with accordingly. Now, what does she have on your brother? Okay. Kyrie, you already know how I'm finna come. It's about to get real physical around here. So I suggest you start talking, or there goes your ass along with Brittany and Brian's.
Brian has a 57-year-old sugar daddy that lives in Atlanta. I'd like to be granted full immunity from all further action from you.
Close my door on your way out.
Tamika, what is this about?
When I am ready for one of y'all to speak, I will inform you.
But I just don't understand why I'm here.
Now, if I knock your head off your shoulders, would you then be able to comprehend what I meant when I said I will inform you when I am ready for you to speak?
The thing is, you're popping off at the mouth about everything but the reason I'm in here. And Tamika, please understand that I've never been scared of you. You ain't gotta be scared to get your ass beat.
Mama, I can explain. I was just bored and went online and found somebody who said he would buy me stuff.
That's not my concern. My concern is that you find her more terrifying than me.
I don't.
So why didn't you tell me about Mr. Earl Gibson in Atlanta?
I didn't know how you was gonna react if you found out.
Trick. I am ready for you to speak. Oh, I can speak now?
That bag has quite a few swings left in it.
Look, I don't owe nobody no exclamation.
Explanation, stupid.
And you're right. You owe me nothing. I knew what type of time you was on when I let you stay here. I just wanted you to prove me wrong. You have 2 minutes to go upstairs and get your stuff and get out of my house. Here's what you're gonna do. You are going to clean out Mr. Earl Gibson's bank account and give me all of it. Every last cent. Or I can beat your ass and you still clean out Mr. Earl Gibson's bank account and give me all of it. Every last cent. Fine. Outstanding. Versace, I don't hear you moving up there. All right, Mama, I'm about to head to the skating rink.
That didn't sound like you were asking me, more like telling me. Well, I mentioned this to you yesterday.
I remember. I said that I would think about it. I didn't give you an official answer.
Mama, can I go to the skating rink?
With who?
Jared, Corey, and Miles.
Well, I've never met them, so that's a red flag. What time were you supposed to be coming home?
I was going to be back around 12 or 1.
Something's not quite right. The skating rink closes at 10. It only takes you 30 minutes to get home, so you would have arrived here at 10:30, not 11 or 12. That's another red flag.
Okay, I'll be home at 11. We were just hanging out after that.
Okay, I see. So you had intentions on doing more than just the skating ring and you weren't going to tell me about it. That is a total of 3 red flags and your evening is now canceled.
So I can't go to the skating ring?
No. However, you can get out of my kitchen and go to your room.
Mama, may I go to the movies with my friend Trey to see Spider-Man?
And then can I go to the mall afterwards?
I'll be sharing my location with you while I'm out.
That sounds legit. Call me when you get there, son.
This is my friend, Carmen.
I am honored to finally meet you. Savon talks about you all the time.
We were just gonna go upstairs and play video games.
You play video games? Oh, no, ma'am. I was just gonna watch. Savon talks about you all the time.
And what exactly does he say?
Well, that you're a good mom? Savon, if I can't get none in my own home, neither can you.
Mama, it's not like that.
Take her ass to a hotel.
Ma, it's not like that.
So you introduced her for what?
I wanted you to see who I'm bringing to your house.
Okay, and now I'd like to see her out.
Your mom is funny.
Hey. Hello. Look, I wanted to apologize for my mother's behavior the last time we all saw each other. I know she could be a bit much.
A bit, not a lot.
However, I love you, Miss Tamika. But throwing that bag at her didn't make the situation any better.
Jasmine, where are you going with this? Because it sounded like we were on the same page for a slight second, and now it sounds like we're off of the same page. So what are we doing?
But she's agreed to let the past be the past and allow Kyrie to enroll in any school in Texas.
I missed you around here, girl.
I missed you too, girl. Now, where's Savon? Savon?
Yeah, girl. Savon? My boyfriend?
Mom, we about to...
Well, Jasmine is back, so you can go ahead and get rid of Miss Lil Laffy Taffy. Carmen, do not. Do not. I will come over there and take your laugh box. I will rip your laugh box out of your throat. Do not. Is it okay? It looks like it's malfunctioning.
Jasmine, I can explain this. She's just a friend.
It's okay, I understand.
But I'm here now, so she can go.
Who can go?
You, my love. Let me walk you to the door. I've been here since last night. You can go, though. The door's over there. Where you came in. Carmen, I'm asking you to leave. There is no longer a purpose for you. Savon, do you want me to go?
Yes. Quietly.
See, I don't usually ask a second time for a bitch to leave my house. So if you want your bob to stay intact, you'll do what I asked you to do and leave.
You know,
so I have some news. I haven't told my mama yet. I wanted to tell you guys first. I'm pregnant. Do you know what time it is, Tamika? Do you want to meet Jehovah?
It is 5 a.m. Where have you been?
Out, being grown.
I have a serious problem with that.
I don't give a fat rat's ass what you have a problem with, Brian.
You can't be picking and choosing when you want to abandon your motherly duties.
Let me try and find who the fuck you might be talking to.
My question hasn't been answered, though. Where have you been all night?
It is simply none of your damn business.
Okay, so when we sneak out or sneak somebody in, remember that it's none of your business.
Okay, here's where you got the shit ass backwards. This is my damn house. Everything that moves in this bitch, I will know about.
Sup, Kyrie. Is that your name?
All right, go upstairs.
So what type of time we finna be on?
I don't know what my mama got going on and what homeless shelter she retrieved you from, but the same shit applies. Stay out of our way.
And if I don't?
So you don't remember what happened last time all four of us were in the kitchen together?
Y'all scary asses had to jump me because one-on-one was impossible.
You were talking unlimited shit to all three of us, so it warranted a triple attack in one.
Y'all really ain't about that life. All y'all finna do is talk shit, jump, then get grounded.
Okay, so now you know what type of time we finna be on.
Well, at this time, this house is a mess, so clean it. All of y'all, or I'm gonna tell y'all mama y'all not listening to me.
Boy, you must have forgot. We don't give a fuck if you tell our mama. Why you acting brand new, Greg?
It's a brand new year and a brand new Greg. Y'all real life scared of y'all mama. So disrespect me while I'm here and I will expose everything y'all do in this house.
So you gonna snitch during the pillow talk?
Absolutely. All sneaky shit will get reported if I get disrespected.
What y'all down here doing?
Oh, nothing, baby. The boys were just about to wash the dishes and clean the house.
Savon, you are so lucky Jasmine's recent pregnancy test was negative.
Okay, mama.
I don't want no more grandkids, Savon. So if you can't pull it out, then tell my dear Jasmine she needs to learn how to chug it. Ma!
Ma, what is the deal with Greg?
The deal is mama gotta have a life too.
Well, damn, how many lives do you need to have?
Mama, somebody ate the rest of my Cheerios.
We didn't do it. Baby, we need some more Cheerios. I ate the last box.
Greg, that was Kyrie's last box.
Yeah, well, he needs some more Cheerios. I ate the last box.
No, you need to buy him a new box of cereal, Greg. That's not fair.
Kyrie!
Yeah!
I like that shit.
I don't know why you have him here, mama, but he's gonna get touched every time I see him, and I want my new cereal by the end of the business day.
What's up, Lace Front?
Hey, Section 8, how are you?
Bitch, I will Section 8 your entire head off your shoulders.
I wanna see that.
Tamika, where is my baby?
Upstairs taking a nap. He was really tired when you dropped him off earlier. It seems like he's not getting enough sleep at home, you know, with all the roaches crawling all over his face.
Jasmine, go find you something safe to do.
Bitch, I'm in safe mode. What you need to do is get my baby off that pallet of blankets that you have on the floor and buy him a real bed.
Your baby?
Jasmine, do you want to take a trip to the emergency room? Because I'm about to reach out and touch you.
Then reach.
And my baby has his own room and bed.
A mattress on the floor by itself with no foundation is not a bed.
Okay. The baby is upstairs if you want to go get him.
Hey, Brian, Mama asked me to cut Miss Diana's grass, but I ain't doing that shit, so I'm gonna need you to do it.
Kari, leave me the fuck alone.
No, I just asked you to do something.
Yeah, but Mama asked you to do it.
She did. She did ask me to do it, but I'm not doing it. You are.
I'm not. Now get the hell out of my face, ho.
But you are, Brian. I will turn your whole world upside down right now.
Okay, so turn it, bitch.
You are really testing my patience. I overheard a little conversation last night about you trying to sneak your boyfriend in tonight after Mama goes to work, but we both know I will fuck that up. So go cut her grass like I asked you to.
Well, I can fix that. He just won't be sneaking in tonight. Mama!
I'ma cut Miss Diana's grass for Kari.
I don't give a damn who cuts it, it just better get cut.
Okay.
Thanks, bro.
Fuck you, nigga.
Hey, Ma, I'm about to start rapping.
You wanna start what?
Rapping! Because I'm good at it. You want to hear something?
Oh, I was in here watching.
Yo, check it. It's Young Vaughn on the track. Hey.
What the rest of it at?
I used to work at Chick-fil-A, but that My Pleasure shit wasn't working for me. Now I'm self-employed and working for me, and the pleasure's all mine the way it's supposed to be. Yeah.
Don't do that ever again. It is not for you. Close my door on your way out.
Listen, I can always make time for you. All right, I'll talk to you later. Boom! Yeah. Hurry! You can't be sneaking up on people like that, boy. Listen, I don't know what you think you heard, but you ain't hear shit. That was just my friend. Greg, where my mama at?
She's upstairs. She'll be down in a minute.
What y'all doing? Hi, Mama. Hi, how are you? Oh my God. So, I just wanted to let you know that I finally have enough money to get my dream car.
I thought you were using Savon's car.
Mama, I still need my own car.
Okay, so go get it. You said you saved enough money.
I'm short $1,000.
Then I suggest you save up some more.
Mama, please. Mama, please. When you want something. I don't really know if I like you like that right now, Brian. Didn't you sneak somebody in my house the other night?
I did see somebody sneaking up in here last night.
Greg, you're broke and living off of my mama. You should never speak. Ever.
How much is this dream car of yours?
It is none of your business, Gregory.
It's none of my business, but you're over here asking us for our money.
My mother's money that she worked hard for? You don't even own a bank account, Greg. The only thing you own is a wallet, and even that's in the negative. Keep talking shit, because when she gives me that $1,000, I might consider giving you some of it, because you clearly need a phone. What are you talking on? What is that in your hand?
It's a phone.
It flips. What kind of phone flips? Okay, I'll think about it, but don't hold your breath.
Mama, don't worry about it. Greg actually told me before y'all came down here that he was gonna help Brian out.
What?
He said that he was gonna use some of the money from his unemployment check and his disability check.
Boy ain't got no damn disability.
My apologies. He was on his phone earlier, and I heard him tell somebody that he was gonna help Brian out with his car.
Is that true?
Yeah.
That's nice of you. Okay. I need to run to the store and get some groceries. You coming with me?
Yeah. I'm coming. What the hell just happened? I happened.
Savon, tell mama you the one who be touching the air.
Yeah, I'll be touching the air.
I'm talking about the AC.
The AC? Why would I touch the AC? It's too cold.
You turned the heater on last night because your whole ass was cold when you got out the shower.
So did I touch the AC or the heat? I'm confused.
You look confused. You didn't finish high school, so I don't expect you to understand.
I don't. You said I touched the air. Then you said I touched the AC. Then you said I touched the heat.
You did!
Are you trying to say thermostat?
Yes!
The thing that you touched because it got hot, so you turned it off?
Bitch, you're the one who turned it on in the first place! Brian LaShawn, watch your mouth! Neither one of y'all pay bills in this house, so nothing you do not pay for should be touched.
Mama, it be cold.
Put some damn socks on! And I don't want to hear that shit because both y'all asses be sleeping with fans on in 30 degree weather. No wonder why y'all cold. Turn the damn fan off. Now touch my shit again and I'm breaking everybody's fingers. I don't care if you didn't touch it.
Okay, and that needs to include Kyrie too.
What about Kyrie? Because you be turning the AC on when it's hot. Mr. Powerbottom, what are you be doing with that Astro Glide from Walmart? Shut your ass up. You can't even spell Astro Glide. A-S-T-R-O. You are a bottom and a hoe.
Baby, it got cold, so I turned the heater on.
Gregory, do you pay any bills in this house?
The better question is, who are you going to sleep with tonight? Your 7-inch toy or a 13-inch Greg?
Y'all don't touch my shit again. I'm talking to the boys. I'm talking to the kids. Don't touch my shit again. I don't pay shit in here.
Do y'all think I'm a joke? No one said that.
Did I ask for you to speak?
You asked a question, Mama.
In your mind, it sounds like a question. In my mind, I'm still speaking, and I am not ready for you to speak.
So how do I know if it's a question or not?
Keep talking, Brian, and I'm going to hit Savon.
Mama, you do realize I'm 19 now.
You're right. You're right. You're 19. So I'll be squaring up with you and tap dancing on your brother's asses.
I didn't drink your Stella Rosa.
I do not recall asking who drank it. I just know that it's gone. That's a problem for me. Y'all have 5 seconds to tell me who's going first. And if no one answers, I'll just start from oldest to last. Okay. 1, 2, 5.
Now try again, because I said I didn't drink it. Like,
Savon, you are very fast. But I wonder how quickly you can stop these.
Greg, it was Greg. Why are you yelling?
Did you drink my Stella?
I ain't drink no damn Stella.
Baby, I'll buy you some more. One of these days, Savon, I'm gonna beat your ass. You think because you're 19 that mama can't touch you, but I can. Gregory, you go in my Stella again without my permission, and I'm gonna call your fifth baby mama and give her your social security number. Now, you said you were gonna buy me some?
Yes.
With what fucking money? Go upstairs and get my purse.
Baby, what if they had all the flavor you like?
Then I would start worrying about what LaTanya is gonna do with your social security number.
Look, baby.
I want my damn Stella. Tonight. Take the boys with you. They can be very helpful. Jasmine, can you please stop posting pictures with my baby?
Savon, do you have a problem with me posting your child on my Instagram? I didn't think so.
I'm the mother and I'm asking you to stop making it like I'm not the picture.
But you are not in the picture and I'm not gonna stop posting my baby on my profile.
I've always wondered if your hands can back up the shit you talk.
I already got your baby daddy. His mama loves me. Your child is getting attached to me and detaching from you. I don't need to fight you. I've already won.
You can have Savon. I don't want him or his mama.
Versace, listen, I'm not about to go back and forth with a bitch that's below my tax bracket.
What the hell is a tax bracket?
Something that you cannot obtain.
Listen, I might not have daddy's money like you, but I take care of me and my child.
Happy Mother's Day. Here are your flowers. You're awesome. If you want me to stop coming for your motherhood, then stop coming for me.
But you wish somebody was telling you Happy Mother's Day and talking about your motherhood.
Girl, I'm focused on being a lawyer and buying a house, not being someone's unwanted baby mama in someone's dodged bullet.
You done? You had enough? Because if you can't afford daycare, then what makes you think you can afford to go back and forth with me?
Baby, I wanted you to meet my lovely mother, Beverly.
His only mother, his biggest supporter, his first love. And did I mention his only love?
Mama, this is my woman, Tamika.
Gregory, baby, I'll be the judge of that. How old are you and what are your intentions with my son? I'm just trying to get to the bottom of who you are. My son says you've been feeding him, clothing him.
I don't clothe him. When Greg moved in, he moved in with 3 pairs of outfits and 1 pair of shoes from Walmart. He is still wearing those 3 pairs of outfits and those 1 pair of shoes from Walmart.
Well, that's just sad. Gregory, when you lived with me, didn't I give you the best?
Mama, I'm 45 years old with 10 kids. I can't live with you forever.
I know, baby, but Mama wants to make sure she's taking real good care of you, like I did.
And how exactly are you taking care of him?
If you cannot answer any of my questions, what makes you think I'm going to answer yours?
Look, Miss Banana.
Who's Banana? I don't see a banana.
Is that not your name? Greg, this conversation with me and her has lasted longer than I've liked it to. Why is she here?
Her name is Beverly, baby. And my mama gonna stay here for the weekend.
In his room and in his bed.
Greg don't have his own room. He sleeps in my bed with me.
Doing what exactly?
It's starting to smell like a Lifetime movie in here. Look, Greg, I don't know what you thought was going to happen with me and her, but it's not going to happen. It's just not. I don't even go back and forth with the bitches that you be texting on your phone. What makes you think I'm gonna go back and forth with your mother / lover?
Just because you don't have a relationship with your sons like mine is not my fault.
Oh, I do have a relationship with my sons. It's just not a physical relationship.
Tamika.
Greg, what you and your mama got going on?
Stop.
Are you laying the pipe on your mama?
No. Mama, I'm gonna get you a hotel.
A hotel? Will you be coming with me?
Oh, y'all got a freaky mother and son relationship. Hotels too?
Can you stop?
Look, Biscuit.
Beverly.
That's what I said. Your son won't be here that long. I just need something other than a toy to play with. When I get tired of looking at him, I'll send him back to you.
I could take my baby home with me right now if I wanted to.
Then take him. I am not about to compete over a man, a 45-year-old man, who is still nibbling on his mama's titties.
Tamika!
Come off the titty, Greg.
You know what? I've had enough of her, Gregory. She's not the one. I'm the one. Can't you see? Where's the nearest exit? Let's go, Gregory.
Look at her, she fiending for you.
You're just jealous of us.
I'm actually disgusted. You clearly want your son more than I do. So please take him, please.
Gregory, go pack your stuff.
Yes, go get your 3 Adidas hoodies and your FUBU tennis shoes from Walmart.